So we call this meeting of the January 4th Library Commission to order. And Sarah, can you take the roll, please?
Sure. President Scheer?
Here.
Vice President Faulkner?
Here.
Commissioner Pangarliotis?
Present.
Commissioner Aronson? Commissioner Lee?
Present.
Olivia?
Here.
Hi, everyone.
Hello. Okay, so we have that. Ooh, I see what I'm doing here. I'm scrolling and blocking the camera. So, Olivia, you want to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance?
Sure. I pledge allegiance
to the flag United of the United States of America
and to the Republic for which it stands,
one nation under one God,
with indivisible,
and justice for all.
Well, it's a good thing we weren't singing something. All right, so next item is the approval of the agenda for tonight's
so
meeting.
So moved.
A motion to approve. Is there a second?
Second.
Moved and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right. Sarah, I think that unless you need the roll call, I think it's okay.
Yeah, I think you can do that. If you want to raise your hands too, I think that works. Okay. I mean, you could say aye and raise your hand. For those, yeah.
Okay. If there's no confusion from that, then we'll move on to the approval of minutes. Sarah, are you
all
good?
Moved.
Yes.
Okay.
So motion. Moved.
Okay, we have a motion for the minutes from October 5th.
Second.
Moved and seconded. All in favor of last year's last minutes?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. All right. That sounds like that stands approved. Is that correct, Sarah?
Yes.
Okay. Announcements and introductions. Do we have any announcements and or introductions?
Denise has some and so do I, so she can go.
Sorry, no, I don't. I was sorry. I was just moving.
Okay. I would like to announce that our newest council member, Peter Kraut, has reappointed me to the Library Commission for a 3-year term. So you stuck with me again. And I'd also like to make note of the fact that Fred Gaines, our retiring council member, who was such a great member of the Library Commission for so many years and was an excellent council member, and has retired. We will miss him, and we are hoping that Peter Kraut coming in will be as interested in the library as Fred was all the time. That's my announcement.
Great. Thank you. All right. I don't think there are members of the audience here. Is there any oral communications?
No.
All right, seeing none, or hearing none, rather. Thank you, sir. new business already. So we're going to reorganize ourselves, do our little dance. I'd like to nominate Michelle as Faulkner as our next commission president or chairperson or whatever you want to call them.
Second.
Moved and seconded. All in favor?
Wait,
there's
Ellen being our next, how about Ellen being the next president?
Well, it's not an order. We rotate in order of who came when.
Okay.
Thank you for the thought. All right, so all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. All right. Sarah, do you have that?
I do. Thank you.
Okay. Raise your hand. No, I'm kidding. Okay. And then, Michelle stands approved. And Michelle's not here tonight, is she? Wait, did I see her?
She is. She's waving both hands.
I can't. I only see you. I only see the speaker. I got to change to gallery view. Here. That would be helpful.
I'm here.
Okay, great. So would you like to take over at this point and do the vice chair?
Okay, do we have nominations for vice chair?
I'd like to nominate Ellen Pangliotis for vice chair.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
Everybody in approval, raise your hand, please.
Aye.
I got that, thank you.
I think that carries. The next thing on our agenda is a Hidden Hills report. Is Brett available?
I think that Barbara is going to be giving it.
Okay, Barbara.
I have two reports to give tonight. And since we're not voting on anything, it's just informational. A lot of it's kind of a redundant. So I'm going to try to kind of them together. The Hidden Hills report is due in September of each year. I was a little late this year. I think just because of COVID, I got distracted with the other things that were going on. But the reports are both on listed on the website. So for specific details, people can look and read it. So I'm just going to go over some of the overview of things. And I think that as I said in the staff report, some of the budget numbers are a little different in the Hidden Hills report as opposed to the City of Calabasas annual report, just because we have different reporting dates. Sarah actually gave me figures for each of the reporting dates. So we pay bills at different times. So you might see a few discrepancies in that, but everything is listed in the Hidden Hills report on line item, so everyone could look at that and see the information. And of course, the biggest thing this year was the closing of the library building due to COVID, but that didn't stop the library from operating. And I have to say this right away about the staff. I think I said this at the last meeting, but our staff is really just incredible. I mean, Carolyn and Jason from IT got every student, teacher, and staff member from LVUSD into our Polaris database so that they can continue their schoolwork right away. There was not like it was probably a 2-day lag, and then everyone started working for online school. And I wonder, Olivia, did that work for you? Were you able to continue
working? Yeah, I actually am using some of the library's online databases and stuff for like my teachers having us use it for a research report we're doing.
Right, good to hear that. And you know, we worked with LVUSD media staff to the librarian there. So as soon as the school closed and the library closed, building closed, Tina got right, you know, we communicated and she told us what they needed and we bought all the digital materials, just whatever they wanted. So I think that was really successful, which I'm glad we really had that student success grant a few years ago. So we were all used to doing that and sharing digital resources. So the overview of the Hidden Hills report is in a 3-week period, starting at our closure date, there was a 500% increase in the Canopy streaming video use. A lot of the teachers used our streaming video to teach classes. 880 new patrons signed up for the Cloud Library. 2,899 Cloud Library eBooks were checked out, which was almost double from January. 662 Gale eBooks reviewed, and 2,381 Gale database uses were reported. And the librarians answered questions round the clock from teachers and students, you know, all of a sudden panicking. How do I get on eBook? How do I use the databases? So we, you know, the staff really stepped up with that. And then the state of California also, the library provided provided us with with several databases for research and teaching at no cost for the new year. So they got some of those federal funds to provide additional databases. So that was a perk. One of the newest things that happened this year was one of our online resources, RB Digital, was sold to a new vendor. And because of this, we instead transferred all our downloadable audiobooks to the cloud system. So that's a change you'll see. The language learning database, we switched from transparent languages back to Mango. So there's a couple different changes that are happening in 2021, and you'll see that for the eBooks. But we try and work with the school district, get what they want for all the digital materials. We also last year bought a lot of physical, I don't want to say a lot, but we bought additional physical materials for their 360 program. So we have a shelf for that at the library, and those check out. I want to know if Britt wants to add anything for the Hidden Hills report.
Yeah, if I might. Thank you, Barbara, first of all. And secondly, I think that honestly, probably you're a little late on it also because of me, and I didn't review it in time. And so I wanna be accountable for that as well. As the ex officio member, I was on with Fred and Ellen back in the early 2000s, might even have been the late 90s. So I'm glad that you were reappointed, Ellen. And as far as the Hidden Hills report, I really want to express how much work this is sort of, you know, seen as a gift to the city of Calabasas, but it really ends up being a whole other job for Barbara. And I want to thank you for all the extra work that goes into finding, you know, the extra materials and trying to accommodate the schools and also, you know, the Board of Education, and it was Dan and all the different players that are involved. It's not as sort of simple as she makes it seem. And I certainly, appreciate all the work that you've done this year, especially because I really feel that this grant this year has had an especially productive and, if you know, just a really important impact on the community. And it really is because of all the work that you do, Barbara. So I just really want to thank you, because even though it's just this like, oh, it's great, it's this great gift, it really creates a lot more work for you. And so I, you know, thank you. And thank you for making such a thorough report and for including everything. And, you know, and just as a reminder, the reason why I always stay silent on everything, I don't know if Olivia knows, is that as the ex officio member, I don't have voting ability. So I tend to be quiet on it. So when you see me, it's not that I'm not agreeing, it's that I'm not able to vote. And so just also as a reminder to the other commissioners as well. But anyway, thank you so much for doing that, and great report.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. And, you know, I stressed in the report about the LVUSD aspect of it, but I just want to remind everyone too, is to provide library services to the citizens of Hidden Hills. And we treat them like Calabasas citizens because they are part of our library network now. So part of the Calabasas Library. So we appreciate everything that, we really appreciate the Hidden Hills residents. They're wonderful people. We love working with them, for them, and appreciate working with you too. So thank you.
Thank you.
If I can continue on to the City of Calabasas annual report. Mark, no, Michelle.
Yes, please. Okay?
So, you know, every year I have to do the state, a big statistical report for the California State Library. And that is not due until November. So after I submit all the numbers for that, then I do this, you know, a report with pictures and just flesh it out. So that's what you see before you. And again, you know, we had, it's from fiscal year 1920. So it seems a little old. You'll see some of these things. You're like, did that really happen? Because we forget what it was like before COVID. But it includes last summer. And we had some great programs before COVID happened. We had an art reception with a young man from Viewpoint who took pictures of what remained from his burnt out home from the Woolsey fire. We had an older gentleman who had taken pictures of the damage to the trees and nature from Woolsey fire. And we had the full fire department come and dignitaries from the city. So that was wonderful. Our summer reading program that last year was great. It was, we had a big festival and we combined it with the Historical Society anniversary. And then throughout the year, we had authors. We had Susan Orlean talk about the library book. And we did it in cooperation with the Ventura County Libraries, CME and Ventura County Public Library and TO. So that was fun. And then we had Lee Goldberg, and we had a couple hundred people for the Lee Goldberg event. So, you know, we had all these things happen and then bam, COVID hit. And again, I have to say the library staff, they're just so wonderful. They didn't miss a beat. It was like the city manager said, close the library. The next day we closed the library, we got all sorts of programs online. Again, Carolyn and the IT department got all everything going. Jill and the hourly librarians started all sorts of online story times. The other hourly librarians came in and actually did reference answer the phones. Shuchandra and Shanta just started the appointment-based checkout right away, implemented everything. Sarah couldn't do it without her because she processes all the new books and she does all the bills. So we never, there was no lag time in paying any of the bills. So it's been crazy, but I think we're still provided really good services to our patrons. Let me tell you a couple other things that we did. You know, we continued all our adult programs too. We still have the book clubs online. We have the Film Fanatics online, Study Buddies. I know Olivia is going to talk a little bit more about the young adult programs when we do the librarian report. One of the kind of the cool things we did this year were drive-by events where we advertised it and we put together bags of, one was for summer reading, all the summer reading materials, and Jill had people drive by and handed it to them. And then this year too, this isn't really from the last fiscal year, but this is coming up in my librarian report too, that we are providing science bags where we put together projects, science projects for kids, and people drive by and get the materials, and then the instructions are online. This year, we had some change in personnel. Nita Torres got her library degree and got a job as the director of Pomona Library right away. So she left. We were sad to see her go, but she's doing great. And we promoted Chandra Ghosh to circulation supervisor and Shanta Williams to take Chandra's place as technical services coordinator. So that's been successful. They've been working with the clerks. We had to furlough. We did not furlough them. They furloughed themselves. We had three clerks furlough themselves, and we have two clerks who work with us regularly. And they have been really working hard to do this appointment checkout, to shelve the books. We are quarantining all the books for 72 hours after they come in. We've been fine free since this time. And we're just continuing along. I'm trying to think if there's anything else in this report. You could see, if you look at the report, you see we still are, you know, our books were still, the physical collection still checked out the most, because this, I don't know what's going to be like in the next year, but for this fiscal year, the collection use was still primarily with physical items. And of course, I talked about the cloud library use increased so much, and the streaming video. Just trying to go through and see if there's anything else. I think that's mainly it. Oh, we also, another personnel change was, I talked about him before, but Jason Robinson took over Andy Hong's position. Andy got a job at the Manhattan Beach Police Department. He was our IT guy, and we really miss him too. We're still meeting with the Friends of the Library on a monthly basis. I take the back, on a quarterly basis. We'll be meeting this Wednesday at, I believe it's at 6 p.m. this Wednesday, if anyone wants to attend. But that's just a quick run through. And if you have any questions, please ask me and I'll try and answer them. Ellen?
Yes, I'd like to know, this is a budgetary one. You've got a whole bunch of digital stuff. Is that gonna come in on budget or over budget, but we're under budget on other things because of other allocations?
You know, this year, they actually added a whole bunch of money to our digital budget. So it should be okay.
Right.
Yeah. And you're right. From last fiscal year, we did order a lot more things in April and May. But as you say, it kind of comes out in the wash. We didn't spend $472,000. So that goes into our reserve fund.
Thank you. Great report.
I have a question.
Yes, Britt.
So I've been advertising all of the stuff on the Hidden Hills page, that all the extra activities and stuff. And like you were talking about that bag. So the science bag, are items like that also available to Hidden Hills residents, or is that just Calabasas residents?
Oh, no.
That is them too. Okay, good.
Yeah. Oh, perfect. For sure. Yeah, any of our programs are available to anybody.
Okay, cool.
Really, but yeah, anything that we have is, you know, the library, everything is free and available to everyone.
Yeah, you know, like even the book, the reading the reading log that you just sent out, the contest that you guys are doing, just even that, the a lot of the adults really like that. In our community, a lot of the seniors really like all that same programming, and just like the bags and all that kind of stuff. It's like, it's fun. So I just want to make sure that it's accessible to them well.
Absolutely.
Cool. Thank you.
And, you know, when I was talking about the Hidden Hills report, we try to do a lot of outreach. Before we close, we'd go into all the schools, we'd go to farmers markets. Now with COVID, we're trying to do a lot more things through our social media.
Yeah.
So you can always include our social media links.
Have all of that. I'm on Facebook. We have a private Facebook page. So I see everything that you guys post on Facebook, and I post it on ours. So, it seems like it gets a pretty good response just with the, you know, people liking it and stuff. Sometimes they don't, sometimes they do, but I think they see it, you know?
That's good to know.
Are there any plans in terms of reopening, in terms of like what phase we would be able to reopen, or?
You know, that is, we had a reopening plan from April and it was never instituted. It really has to do with what the city management did. I think I told you in the last meeting, I go to, I attend Zoom meetings every 2 weeks that are held by the California State Library for all the library directors. And some of the libraries that opened completely had to close, including their curbside pickup, their checkout, their, you know, appointment checkout, because the staff got it.
Right.
And so, and now especially, you know, we did all the PPE. If you can see on the annual report, you see the plexiglass up over the CERC desk, and we have, you know, got all the masks and the gloves and the wipes. And then this happened again with, you know, it's so bad. The numbers are so bad now. So your guess is as good as mine. I mean, you know, with the vaccine, I'm hoping we all get vaccinated and then open up. I just saw Glendale sent me an email today. The Glendale Public Library director said that they just had to close down their whole operation, including curbside, because a couple of the staff got COVID. So I'd love to open, but it doesn't look like we're opening until we get word from LA County Public Health Department.
We'll keep our fingers crossed. Thank you. Yeah.
But meanwhile, we still want to, you know, we want to keep saying that we're not closed, just the building's closed. Anything else? Should I give the librarian's report now?
Yes, please.
Okay. Well, besides everything I just talked about, we have some more exciting news. They applied for a grant to develop online adult programs. To have some like instructional and fun things. And I applied for a $2,500 grant and they said, how about if we give you
$5,000?
Wow. I was like, okay. So I put together, you know, a whole grant proposal for the spring. I was going to call it Spring into Creativity. But now if we're getting extra money, we'll probably extend it into summer. And it's for adults, and it's going to be like, we're going to provide kits that we'll hand out as, you know, either by, you know, at the front door or drive by. And it'll be things like painting and knitting. I can't remember. I had like 16 different things. Cooking. We're going to continue with our yoga. And so we hope to keep doing that. So that's nice. One of the things I said about in the grant was the friend, we used to pay for these programs from money from the Friends book sale. But since we've been closed, there's been no revenue for the Friends. So that's kind of a shame. So I'll let you know some further details. I'll send you emails when we actually get all these online programs going. Let's see what else we had for the months of November and December. We had 751 people actually come to the front door of the library to check out books. In those 2 months, we had 5,898 physical materials go out. We are getting a new app, which is kind of cool. It's through III. Polaris was taken over by III. So sometimes I use those. I say Polaris, but it's also III. It's to use your phone to check out materials, because we were thinking, well, if we reopen a little bit at a time and this COVID is still bad, when you come in the library, you can take a book off the shelf, pull up your library card and check it out on your phone. and walk out. So and it wasn't all that much money, and we thought it was kind of a groovy little gadget to have. So, you know, we're trying to stay up, you know, stay up to speed with technology. So you'll see that implemented in the next couple months. We have the thing Brett was talking about with Beanstack, which is an online reading challenge that we got from the California State Library, and Jill Nevins has been working on that to implement that. And so everybody look on our website and sign up and put down all the books you've read. And speaking of books to read, we keep getting new books. So we have nice new books at the library. I just want to let people know, if you want to put them on hold, go call the reference librarian to put them on hold for you. You can make an appointment and take out these books. And again, we're trying to be very safe. It's, we only have the appointments every 15 minutes. So people aren't, you know, passing each other. We have a whole system. We make you back up 6 feet. We put them on a chair, and then you can approach the library. So you'll see circulation. If you want to check some of the books out, circulation could tell you how to do that. Olivia, would you like to say some things about the young adult programs?
Yeah, so I'm just gonna briefly talk about Study Buddies first. So we took a break for the holidays, obviously, but now it's restarting again this week. The January dates are every Tuesday. So I believe it's the 5th, the 12th, the 19th, and the 26th. And every day it's 3:30 to 5:30. And tutors and students who want to be tutored can sign up online through the Google form. It's on the City of Calabasas website, the library calendar of events. You can find more information there, or you can email Carolyn. Her email is also on the page. And then also, I just wanted to talk about the Writers Club. It's the Writers Corner Club. It's for third through seventh graders who like creative writing, and you don't need any prior experience or anything. It's hosted by the library, but it's run by high school students. And it's only one Saturday every month. The first meeting is on the 9th of this month at 3:30, and it's on Zoom, so it's all COVID safe. And then again, to sign up, you just email Carolyn, and more information about this is also on the Calabasas website, as is her email.
Thank you. We already have our January calendar out. We've had it out for a couple days, and our e-news, people could sign up for our e-news and get all the information. And that's it for me. I've been talking a lot. So turn it back over to Michelle. Stop talking.
Okay. Does anybody have any future agenda items they'd like to propose? Ellen?
Yes. I have one that will involve the CFO if we think this looks like it would be a good idea to check before we have to get into our budget in July. We're not sure what the property tax ramifications are going to be in the city of Calabasas because of COVID, between the monies that we get from commercial properties, business properties, and homes. So I think that it would be a good idea to get an update from the CFO on some of the following things. And for ease with Sarah, I'll send this list by email so that if you miss something as I'm saying it, you can know that it's coming. I think that because of what's going on, we have differences in the amount of monies that were projected for things like facility maintenance, equipment maintenance, utilities. For example, on the electric utilities, we don't have our computer room running. And so all the people that would come to the computer room are using electricity. And since we don't need that, perhaps we'll be able to get some money from that that we can apply to stuff that we really need for the library. Also, the water bill and the gas bill, how many hourly employees stayed with us or furloughed. the phone bill, office supplies, postage, and computer maintenance. So I'd like the CFO to give us an update on what they projected and what the actuals are till April when we meet again. That's it.
Okay. Thank you. Does anybody else have a future agenda item? Okay. Seeing none, I think we are ready to adjourn. Do I have a motion to adjourn the meeting?
So moved.
Second.
Thank you. Second. Okay. All in favor, raise your hands. Okay. Barbara, do we know the date of our next meeting?
Yes. It's April 5th. Right, Sarah?
Yes.
Is that in between Passover and Easter?
You know what? It's actually the Monday right after Easter, right? So does that work for people?
Fine. Not a problem.
Not a problem. I don't think we're going anywhere.
Yeah. Because maybe we'll all be vaccinated and we'll meet in person.
Yeah, do you think? Do you think? Yeah.
No.
I don't think.
I sure hope so.
Yeah, I don't think. I think probably maybe summer.
Wish and hope.
Yeah, I hope.
Who knows? Okay, if there are no more issues, this meeting is adjourned. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Everybody, stay safe and stay well.
And congratulations.
Great job, Michelle.
Thank you.